So here we are. It's late January 2019 and Dean Ambrose is on the verge of leaving WWE. What the hell? Here's what we know so far. Pro Wrestling Torch broke the news this very morning, January 29th, claiming that Ambrose had given his notice over Royal Rumble weekend. The contract that Dean is currently on expires sometime after WrestleMania 35, towards the end of April. Now, there is every chance he could stick around and work the Showcase of the Immortals, but just as likely is WWE writing him out of storylines ahead of time and cutting him off prematurely. Apparently, Ambrose's frustrations run so deep that he was willing to reject a $5 million 5-year contract extension from WWE. The man just wants out, and there's nothing Vince McMahon can do to stop him. Ambrose has hit breaking point. If Pro Wrestling Torch to be believed, the reason behind his decision is long-standing creative frustrations with regards to his character's direction. And honestly, after the past few years he's had, who can blame him? But let's keep it balanced here. Ambrose's WWE run hasn't been without some major highs. He was WWE champion for 3 months, The Shield are wrestling's greatest modern stable, and on top of all that, he is a multi-time mid-card champion as well. But that being said, his discontent is understandable. WWE creative have continually failed him over his run with the company, and when you add all these things together and list them up like I'm about to do, well, it's kind of easy to see why he wants out. So let's run them down. I'm Andy for What Culture Wrestling, and here are 8 legitimate reasons Dean Ambrose has to be unhappy with WWE. Number 8, the entire Bray Wyatt feud. According to the original article, Dean Ambrose, and I quote, hates hokey shit. So, knowing that, I think it's pretty safe to say that he didn't have the best of times working with WWE's master of hokey shit, Bray Wyatt, in 2014. No swearing, keeping it clean for the censors. The feud lasted into the first week of 2015, and it was, for lack of better phrasing, a hurricane of piss. The storyline presented the absolute worst possible versions of both characters. Take Wyatt, for example, whose credibility had long been destroyed by a series of creative misgivings and big pay-per-view losses. His nonsensical babbling promos hadn't yet passed into so bad they're good territory. They were just bad, and Dean Ambrose's content opposite him wasn't any better. Ambrose was made to look like the world's biggest goober, not only for losing to Wyatt 3 times in a row, but for continually falling for his pantomime nonsense. Hell in a Cell 2014 saw Ambrose lose to Seth Rollins because Bray showed up and entranced him with a bloody ghost. Then, at TLC 2014, Ambrose lost via exploding bloody television. Now, these are the most destructive examples, but the feud was full of many more. Number 7, the prop comic era. It might sound ridiculous today, but there was a time when you could genuinely compare Dean Ambrose's character to Brian Pillman's loose cannon persona without a shred of irony. Sadly, though, Ambrose's character lost every shred of danger and edginess within weeks of The Shield breaking up. The OG Seth Rollins feud gave WWE the opportunity to build Ambrose up as the kind of anti-hero that they had built the Attitude Era on 20 years prior, but as we now know, they passed that up. Instead of keeping Ambrose a smart but unpredictable schemer who would destroy opponents physically and mentally, WWE decided to turn him into a rodeo clown, a prop comic, if you will, and that destroyed every hope he ever had of becoming a genuine game changer, which, let's make no mistake, he definitely could have been. To go through a few of the worst examples, Ambrose dressed as the Mountie. He tipped an ice bucket over Seth Rollins' head. He assaulted foes with the contents of hot dog carts and attended therapy sessions, played for laughs. And the worst part is, he still leans into this aspect today, even when he's supposed to be a heel. This wacky character would be a lot more palatable if the comedy was, you know, actually funny, but it isn't. It never has been, it never will be, and instead of getting Ambrose over, it has frequently turned him into a mockery. Number 6. That Brock Lesnar match. WrestleMania 32 gave Brock Lesnar the opportunity to help mint a younger star and undo all the credibility damage done through his prop comic years. But instead of doing that, he just kind of said nah, hand-waved the whole thing, and destroyed Dean Ambrose with one of his most uninspired performances yet in their no-holds-barred street fight, a match that many, myself included, we're really looking forward to. What should have been a wild, out-of-control hardcore spectacle turned into a lame, tame brawl. And in coasting through the match, Lesnar just made Dean look awful. Rather than getting him over in defeat, the one-sided pounding knocked Dean for six, and he somehow left the building even more of a dork than when he'd walked in. Ambrose has made no secret of hiding his disappointment and frustration at the match, and it's perfectly understandable. WrestleMania 32 was an excellent opportunity for him to get back on track, and it all turned to dirt because Brock Lesnar just couldn't be arsed. Number 5. His failed WWE title run. The Great Dean Ambrose rebuild commenced in 2016, with Ambrose winning the Money in the Bank briefcase that summer, then cashing in on new WWE champion Seth Rollins that very same night. His success was amplified when he beat Rollins and Roman Reigns in the long-awaited Shield Triple Threat at Battleground 2016, and the result of that match meant that he was taking WWE's top prize, their World Championship, over to SmackDown, and that he would be a brand-leading star. It didn't really work out that way. The first problem was that WWE had Ambrose go second in the WWE draft that year. I mean, seriously, who doesn't pick their so-called top champion at number one? It sent all the wrong messages. He was then presented with a dearth of top challengers over on SmackDown, apart from AJ Styles, of course. The Dolph Ziggler feud, for example, saw Dean presented as this weird pseudo-heel at a time when fans were really desperate just to cheer for him as a top-level babyface, having waited so long. And then, unfortunately, came that Stone Cold podcast interview, which undermined Dean's standing in the company even further, though that one was of his own doing. Now, don't get it twisted, it is great that Ambrose had a run with the belt in the first place, but his was less than flattering. Number 4. Demoted at WrestleMania 33. WrestleMania 32 was a debacle, but hey, at least Ambrose made the main card. Unfortunately, that wasn't the case 1 year later when his Intercontinental title match with Baron Corbin was demoted to the kickoff show without warning. It played out to a dead crowd who weren't expecting the match at a time when the arena was still filling up. Now, it wasn't exactly the most inspired match in the world, but it's hard to blame the wrestlers for that, given the hand they were dealt. Corbin and Ambrose were shafted by management, and with Dean's buddies Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns fighting Triple H and The Undertaker respectively, he was left picking for scraps on a show nobody was watching. All this so the hardest man alive, Shane McMahon, could get an extra 10 minutes in his ludicrous battle with AJ Styles. Cool. Number 3. Relegating Renee. Renee Young is among the most misused performers in WWE today, and she isn't even a wrestler. She's an excellent broadcaster and far more skilled than Michael Cole, Corey Graves, Dasha Fuentes, Charlie Caruso, or anyone else in a similar role. Put it this way, she's just better than WWE, and she, like her husband, is going to walk away someday. The awesome Talking Smack chat show was taken away from Young in 2016 and relegated to a backstage interview viewing role. She made no attempt whatsoever to hide her frustrations, speaking out on the matter on social media. Now, things seemed to be looking up in September 2018 when Young was made a full-time member of the Raw commentary team, but unfortunately, she has since been turned into a lame, subservient Stepford Wife type character and another victim of WWE's commentary curse. Overproduction is everywhere, and it's knocked her down just like it did Corey Graves and everyone else. These role reshuffles and mistreatment, coupled with the constant exploitation of Ambrose and Young's relationship, have almost certainly played a part in Dean's decision to quit. Number 2. Butchering the Rollins feud. Dean Ambrose versus Seth Rollins should have been the WWE Money program for 2018 and 2019. Built on a controversial heel turn and years of mutual history, WWE should have ridden this thing all the way to WrestleMania 35, culminating in the ultimate blow-off match. Instead, they buried it with complete tastelessness. WWE's writers are simply nowhere near subtle or sharp enough to handle matters like Roman Reigns' leukemia returning with the right level of sensitivity, and this feud is proof of it. Ambrose started wearing a gas mask to the ring, he got himself inoculated, and ridiculously, he claimed, and I quote, that Reigns' leukemia was him answering to the man upstairs for his kayfabe actions. That That's bloody gross. Then there was TLC 2018, and a match so pedestrian and heatless, it belonged on a house show, not as a blow-off match on pay-per-view for what was supposed to be a blood feud. It was, by some margin, the most disappointing match of the entire year. Very few people were satisfied with how things turned out with this feud, and it's hard to imagine that the performers themselves were particularly thrilled either. And number one, wasting his big heel turn. Ambrose's heel turn divided the world. It came, after all, on the very same night that Roman Reigns announced to the world that his leukemia had returned. And the idea that WWE shouldn't exploit such matters for kayfabe heat is certainly a very valuable one. Still, what can't be argued is that the turn got over. Whether right or wrong, Ambrose became the biggest villain in the company in the space of one single evening, and it likely accomplished everything that WWE thought it would. More than anything else, the heel turn gave Dean the opportunity of a fresh start. WWE now had the chance to wash everything away. The disappointing title run, the awful Bray Wyatt feud, all the hokey prop comic nonsense, and guess what? They didn't take it. They could have restored his credibility, they could have brought back his old, dangerous, edgier character, and for once in this lifeless era, actually capitalized on a really hot moment, sending Ambrose to the stratosphere in the process. But WWE didn't do that, and instead, babyface rodeo clown Dean Ambrose became heel rodeo clown Dean Ambrose. He added basic, outdated bad guy fodder, like continually telling the audience how much they smell, but essentially, this new Ambrose was nothing more than a different shade of the same old crap. Given what could have been, it's no wonder he's asked for his release. So that's my take on the issues that may have contributed towards Dean Ambrose wanting to leave WWE. But what do you guys think? Let us know down in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And as always, I've been Andy, and I'll see you later.